Once adulthood rolls around, women are sensitized to men who fit the Prince Charming mold. However, when we look at men, or people in general, there are few who tick all the boxes.
Hello and welcome to my channel. I am the Anti-Woke Warrior. What you just saw was a short clip from a video entitled, Where Have All the Good Men Gone? And it features street interviews of Australian college students at Queensland University of Technology. So let's take a look at the video and see what some of these standards are. But before we do, please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Also, find me on Twitter. I'm over there. You can Anti-Woke Warrior on Twitter. Sometimes I tweet interesting things. But here we go.
Rich?
Well, I'm not rich, so I'm out for that one. Let's see what this lady has to say here.
Great with his words.
I'm definitely out on that one. If you've watched my channel, I am not an eloquent orator. We all know that.
Probably be fashionable.
What do you mean by fashionable? I mean, I'm assuming you mean like dresses in what is considered a nice manner.
He has to be at least this much taller than me.
I'm gonna guess that I'm out on that one because I don't think I'm taller than that woman at all. I don't know how tall she is, but unless she's really short, I'm not that much taller than her.
Has to make me laugh.
Well, I don't know what you find funny.
He has to have blue eyes and smell really nice.
Well, I don't have blue eyes and nobody's ever complained about my smell, so maybe I smell really nice. I don't know.
Handsome. He has to be athletic, so he's a nice tight butt.
Well, I think that I'm handsome. I've been told that I'm handsome, and I am athletic, so I have a nice tight butt.
Has a six-pack.
Okay, that's not impossible for me to achieve. Right now, I think I have a five-pack, so I'm almost there.
Romantic, definitely.
Cannot have commitment issues, but isn't clingy either.
I think I qualify for that one, not sure.
His breasts cannot be bigger than mine.
No, my breasts are definitely not bigger than yours.
And he can't be more than 5 years older. Or 1 year younger.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say I'm 5 years older than you at least. I'm definitely not younger than her.
Has to be able to save me from bugs.
Well, that all depends on what that involves, because if saving you from bugs means I have to pick you up and carry you away from the bugs, that's not gonna happen. I'm guessing that you outweigh me by quite a lot there, Missy.
And loves animals.
Oh, I love animals, so I can mark that one off the list.
Oh my god, he has to be musical.
I am definitely not musical. I don't even really care for music that much, honestly. I wonder how many of those I ticked the box on. I think like 6 out of 20 or so. I'm definitely not dating any of those women. We all know the answer to that question, of course. The answer is women have changed their standards. The men have not stopped being good.
Modern woman is hard-pressed to find the right man for a committed long-term relationship. This idea is scattered throughout Western culture, with numerous articles being written on the topic and movies that toy with the idea. But are men really the ones to blame, or does the modern woman simply set her standards too high?
I'm going to go ahead and explain it as the modern woman sets her standards too high and then also is too busy being hedonistic to be a valuable mate to the man. And then when she's done being hedonistic and figured out that she has no other options, the men are like, yeah, I have no interest in you anymore. You've already wasted everything of value that you could have brought to the table.
From an early age, girls have been raised to want unrealistic male partners.
Disney movies have done this, yeah. Mm-hmm. I've been saying it for years.
For example, reinforce the view of the perfect man as being unobtainably virtuous. He rescues a damsel even if it involves simply opening her eyes to the bigger picture. After overcoming one big setback, the couple lives happily ever after, often knowing each
other. He's bringing a teddy bear and a flower for some girl. Yeah, that always works. Try it, see what happens.
Each other for only a matter of days. These ideas then evolve into popular young adult fiction, television shows, movies, and novels centered on the high school romantic dramas such as Gilmore Girls, Twilight, and Gossip Girl. The obstacles are bigger and the people are more flawed, but they still have a happy ending and the virtues outweigh the vices.
So they're not blaming Disney shows. Gilmore Girls, the other ones that they mentioned that I've never seen. Those weren't Disney programs, as I recall. Maybe they were. But, yeah, this is like teen fantasy, you know, teen fiction, teen romance fantasy or whatever, coming of age stuff, young adult stuff. And yeah, it's really sad that adults are basing their notions of what a relationship should be like on those shows. I mean, we're the parents teaching these people to be, you know, honest, devoted, interested in the other person, etc.
Once adulthood rolls around, women are sensitized to men who fit the Prince Charming mold. However, when we look at men, or people in general, there are few who tick all the boxes.
There are few who even tick a quarter of the boxes. I mean, really, the Prince Charming guy, he's got all the wealth in the world. He's got the ability to dress however is the most stylish at the time. He is an excellent fighter and would defend her honor no matter what. And he would take her no matter who she is and make her life whatever it wants to be with a new high every day so that she never gets bored. Yeah, it's basically impossible.
If you had to pick a gender, who do you reckon had the highest standard?
Probably women.
Men. Easy.
You said men easy. Really? Men have the higher standards, really. So let me see. My standards are you have to be hot and you have to be nice. Okay. Well, what do we see from the women's standards? Oh, he has to like animals. He has to have blue eyes. He has to be so many years, within so many years of my age. She has to have smaller breasts than me. You know, well, that's go under attractiveness. You know, so he has to be attractive. You know that. But he also has to have like superficial stuff like blue eyes. What constitutes attractiveness? One girl said a six pack. Okay. A lot of men are considered attractive who don't have six packs. I mean, where do you draw the line on what is attractive and what isn't? Wow, that woman is delusional. Either that or she was just joking around.
Women.
Men, I think.
Probably the same. Girls do definitely have high standards.
Yep, women for sure.
Women.
Women.
See a lot of Bergens around the place. Men are just like, yee, you know?
We're joined here today by Carly Phillips. Carly has over half a decade of experience in marital communications and relationship counseling.
She has over half a decade. Oh, so she's an expert then, huh? If you said she had like 2 decades, then I would be more impressed. But the fact that she is a marital communications and relationships expert, I'm not really interested in her opinion on relationships. My relationships got a hell of a lot better when I started listening to people in the manosphere. My male-female interpersonal relationships just improved immensely when I stopped listening to what women had to say and started listening to what men had to say about the subject matter.
So, Kylie, who do you think has higher standards, men or women?
I think it really depends on the individual.
Yeah, it really depends on the individual. Wow, imagine that. Some men have higher standards than some other men. Some women have higher standards than some other women. However, overall, women have the higher standards. We see this throughout the entirety of the animal kingdom. There may be an exception here and there, but the female of every species that I've ever seen is the one who is particular in her mating appetite. And it makes sense that the woman would be the more selective because she has more to lose than the man does. The man can show up, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, and then he's gone and the woman never sees him again. Whereas the female could get from that encounter pregnant, and then she has to deal with possibly dying because of the pregnancy. And on top of that, then she has a child to take care of for however many months or years it takes to raise a child. Some species, they're born ready to go. Other species, they're going to take years to raise into adulthood. I don't know why she would even, why she'd even be wishy-washy at all about that notion.
I mean, there are men out there who are, well, wouldn't really even scrape up to the very, very bottom end of most women's standards. But there are, of course, women whose standards are set far too high, unrealistically high.
Is it healthy for people to hold these high standards when looking for a partner?
I think some standards are important when you're looking for a partner. If not just because you want to have something in common with that partner, then at least to weed out those people who would be completely unsuitable for you. However, I think it is dangerous.
Way to state the obvious.
Dangerous for people to have their standards set too high, because the chances of finding somebody who fulfills all of those very highly set criteria is minimal. The key component in any partnership is compromise, after all.
Do you think media is to blame for women's high standards?
I think the media definitely contributes to forming those high standards, but there are other contributing factors such as parents.
Where are parents getting their ideas about relationships from? Most likely the media, in a lot of cases. As we move farther and farther away from having traditional family values, people are picking up values from the media, from pop culture, from politicians and other people that they know who have also gotten the same ideas from media.
And past experiences, past relationships.
Yeah, I know. It's amazing how women gain this information from past experiences. So I asked a girl out once and she said, you know, a guy came in and he said the exact same thing to me that you just said to me, and I ended up dating him for like 2 years and it was a terrible relationship. So I wouldn't want to date you because, you know, you're going to be just like him. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Maybe, but, you know, maybe it's you.
Environment, social situation, all these sorts of things. All of these factors combine to really form an environment, really, in which women are encouraged to develop high standards.
In the course of this...
Biology has nothing to do with it at all. You notice that? Biology had absolutely nothing to do with it. Really, wow. Women, like I said, are predisposed to having high standards because they run the greatest risk when mating. And monogamous relationships are not exactly natural amongst humans. You can have your own opinion about that if you want to. I'm not going to get into that subject matter, but it seems to me that we developed monogamy as a way to keep society functioning, keep civilization functioning. So we didn't have a bunch of men who are out there frustrated that they can't participate in what women have to offer and then become violent and aggressive because they can't get what they need.
Documentary, we have established that women are in fact the gender that holds the highest standards when looking for a partner. With Kylie Phil's help, we explored that both sexes are to blame when it comes to standards. To prevent women from ending up alone, women should cease setting unrealistic high standards. However, they mustn't give up their standards completely. Like Kylie says, relationships are all about compromise and finding someone that you are willing to compromise for.
Couldn't have said it better myself. This is just an interesting, fun video that I wanted to cover because there's so many men out there that are struggling to find a relationship. If you're new to dating and you're new to this sort of information, there's a lot of information out there about what you should be looking for and not doing when you're pursuing women. So don't give up hope if you have your heart set on getting into a relationship. That's all that I got for this time. I do want to remind everybody that I have written my first book, so that should be coming out later on this year. It is a medieval fantasy novel, so if you're interested in that sort of thing, look forward to that. Don't forget to subscribe down below. Thank you for stopping by, and I will see you all in the next video.